Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this solved official exam exercise, we are going to determine the expression of the magnetic flux crossing a rotating coil, determine the expression of the induced electromotive force, determine the expression of the voltage across the coil, calculate the magnitude of the magnetic field, determine the relation between the voltage across the coil and the voltage across a resistor in a series RL circuit carrying a triangular current. Prove that the shape of the voltage across the coil is alternating square, and calculate the inductance of the coil.
A coil of horizontal axis is made up of 500 turns, each of surface area 10 centimeters squared. The coil is rotating at a constant angular velocity, omega, about a vertical axis, delta. The normal end to the planes of the turns of the coil is directed as indicated in the figure. The coil is rotating in a uniform, constant, and horizontal magnetic field, B. The terminals A and C of the coil are connected to the input Y and the ground M of an oscilloscope. Theta is the angle between B and N. Let's start with the electromagnetic induction phenomenon. Question number one. Knowing that theta is equal to zero at time zero, show that theta is equal to omega t. So the angular velocity is constant, which means that this is a uniform rotational motion. The time equation of a uniform rotational motion is given by theta is equal to omega t plus theta zero. But theta zero is equal to zero. Then we still have theta is equal to omega t. Question number two. Deduce that the expression of the magnetic flux crossing the coil is NB as cosine omega t. We know that the expression of the magnetic flux crossing a coil placed in a uniform magnetic field is given by N B dot N times S, where B dot N is the scalar or the dot product of the vectors B and N. The dot product of two vectors is the product of their magnitudes times cosine the angle between them. The magnitude of the unit vector n is 1. Now, what is theta? Theta is equal to omega t. So we will replace theta in this expression by omega t. This is going to be phi is equal to nb as cosine omega t. This is the expression of the magnetic flux crossing the coil.
Part 3. Justify qualitatively the existence of an induced electromotive force during the rotation of the coil. During the rotation of the coil, the angle between N and B changes, so the magnetic flux crossing the coil changes, then an electromotive force is induced in the coil. Part 4. In 4a, determine in terms of NB as omega and T the expression of the induced electromotive force. Using Faraday's law, E is equal to minus d phi by dt, but phi equal nbs cosine omega t proved in the previous slide. Now, nbs is constant and cosine omega t is variable, so the derivative of the flux with respect to time is equal to nbs times the derivative of cosine omega t, and the derivative of cosine omega t is equal to minus omega sine omega t. Therefore, E is equal to nbs omega sine omega t.
Let's move to part 4b. The coil does not carry electric current. Why? Look at the figure. The coil is connected across the terminals of an oscilloscope, and the oscilloscope has a very large resistance, so the coil does not carry an induced current. Part 4c. Deduce the expression of the voltage UAC in terms of NSB omega and T, supposing that the coil is oriented positively from A to C. If the coil is oriented positively from A to C, then UAC is equal to RI minus E
but the current is equal to zero. Then UAC is equal to minus E. In the previous slide, we found the expression of E. So let's replace E in the expression of UAC by NBS omega sine omega t. This is going to be UAC is equal to minus NBS omega sine omega t.
Focus, please. This is important.
Part 5. The waveform represents the voltage across the coil, UAC versus time. Determine the angular frequency omega of the coil. To determine omega, we have to determine the period of rotation of the coil, and the period is given by this formula, x times sh, where sh is the horizontal sensitivity or the time base, which is equal to 10 milliseconds per division, and x represents the number of the horizontal divisions measured over one cycle. Look at the figure. X is equal 1, 2, 3, 4. So replace X by 4 divisions and SH by 10 milliseconds per division. So the period of rotation of the coil is equal to 40 milliseconds. Omega is given by this formula. Omega equal to pi over T. So replace T by 40 times 10 to the power minus 3 seconds. Therefore, the angular velocity of rotation of the coil is equal to 50 pi radians per second. 5b. Determine the maximum value of the voltage UAC. The maximum value of the voltage UAC is given by this formula, SV times YM, where SV is the vertical sensitivity or the amplitude gain. It is equal to 1 volt per division. And YM represents the vertical divisions for a positive peak or for a negative peak relative to the time axis. Look at the figure. YM is equal to 1, 2, 3. So substitute YM by 3 divisions and SV by 1 volt per division. Therefore, the maximum value of the voltage UAC is equal to 3 volts. 5C. Determine the value of the magnitude of the magnetic field. UAC is proved in the previous slide. UAC is equal to minus NBS omega sine omega t. So the maximum value of UAC is equal to the absolute value of minus NBS omega, because sine omega t, or the maximum value of sine omega t, is equal to 1. UAC maximum is equal to NBS omega. Now replace each physical quantity by its value. UAC maximum is equal to 3 volts, N is equal to 500 turns, S is equal 10 centimeters squared, which is equal to 10 times 10 to the power minus 4 meters squared, and omega is equal to 50 pi radians per second. Therefore, B is equal to 0.038 Tesla.
Let's move to the self-induction phenomenon. The coil is of negligible resistance and of inductance L. It is connected in series with a resistor of resistance 1 kilo ohm and a generator G. We will take U1 as UBC and U2 as UAC and the positive sense in the direction of the current. Let's move to part 1. Show that U2 is equal to minus L over R du1 by dt. Now look at the circuit. U1 is equal to UBC, which is the voltage across the resistor, and U2 is equal to UAC, which is the voltage across the coil. Let's start with UAC. Now we follow the positive sense. UCA is equal to RI plus LDI by dt. But UCA is equal to minus UAC and R is equal to 0. Now, we want to replace UAC by U2. This is going to be minus U2 is equal to LDI by DT. Now, this is the expression that we want to obtain it. In this expression, we have du1 by DT. And here we have di by dt. So what is the relation between the current and U1? Again, U1 is equal to UBC. Let's follow the positive sense. UBC is equal to plus Ri. Then I is equal to UBC over R. Replace UBC by U1. Then I is equal to U1 over R. Let's differentiate this equation with respect to time. The derivative of I is di by dt, and the derivative of u1 over r is equal to 1 over r du1 by dt. Now, we will replace di by dt in the expression of u2 by 1 over r du1 by dt. This is going to be minus u2 is equal to L times 1 over r du1 by dt. And finally, we have u2 is equal to minus L over r du1 by dt.
Look at the first figure. The ground of the oscilloscope is connected to point C. And since the phase of channel 1 is connected to point B, then channel 1 displays the voltage UBC equal U1 across the resistor. And since the phase of channel 2 is connected to point A, then channel 2 displays the voltage UAC equal U2 across the coil. The generator G sends a triangular current. Look at the second figure. During the U1 is periodic, and during the first half period, U1 increases linearly with time. And during the second half period, U1 decreases linearly with time. Look at the curve that represents U2. It is alternating square. So in this part, we have to prove that the shape that represents the voltage U2 across the coil is alternating square. We know that U2 is equal to minus L over R times du1 by dt, proved in the previous slide. In the first half period, we observe that U1 increases linearly with time. So U1 has the form of A1t plus B, where B is constant and A1 is the slope of this curve and is given by du1 by dt. It is positive constant. Now replace du1 by dt by A1 in the expression of u2. So u2 equal minus L over R into A1, which is constant. Since A1 is a positive constant, minus L over R is a negative constant. So during the first half a period, U2 is a negative constant as shown on the screen of the oscilloscope. During the second half a period, we notice that U1 decreases linearly with time. So it has the form of A2T plus D. D is a constant and A2 is the slope of this curve, which is a negative constant. Similarly, replace du1 by dt by a2 in the expression of u2, so u2 becomes minus L over R times a2, which is equal to constant. A2 is a negative constant now, minus L over R is also a negative constant, so during the second half period, u2 is a positive constant. So we can conclude that u2 is alternating square.
Let's move to part 2, determine the value of L. In a previous slide, we found the relation between U2 and du1 by dt. To calculate the value of L, we need to determine graphically the values of U2 and du1 by dt. We will use the first half period. In the first half period, this is the curve of U1 and this is the curve of U2. Let's start with U2. Now, this line represents the zero of the voltage U2, and the curve of U2 is one division below this line. Then Y is equal to minus one division. So U2 is equal to SV2 times Y. SV2 is equal to 10 millivolts per division, and Y is equal to minus one division. Then U2 is equal to minus 10 millivolts. Let's move to du1 by dt. So this is the curve of U1 during the first half period. It is a straight line with a positive slope. Because it is a straight line, then du1 by dt is equal to delta U by delta t, which is the slope of this line. Now, how can we calculate the slope? This segment represents delta U, and this segment represents delta T.
delta U extends over one division and delta T extends over two divisions, then delta U is equal to 1 division times the vertical sensitivity SV1, which is equal to 1 volt per division, and delta T extends over 2 divisions. So we have delta T is equal to 2 divisions times the horizontal sensitivity, which is equal to 5 milliseconds per division. Now the divisions cancel out in the numerator and in the denominator, so we have 1 volt over 10 milliseconds. This is going to be 1 volt over 10 times 10 to the power minus 3 seconds, and the answer is 100 volts per second. Now we are ready to calculate L. Let's replace each physical quantity by its value in the above equation. Then U2 is equal to minus 10 millivolts, which is equal to minus 10 times 10 to the power minus 3 volts, and R is equal to 1000 ohms, and du1 by dt is equal to 100 volts per second, then L is equal to 0.1 henries.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.